The backstory, why Vivian?
Let me ask you, did you ever have certain days where you decided, I don't like that person? Is it something the person said? Is it the person doing something? Or is it something the person didn't do? But let me ask you, could it be possible? Just think. No matter what we see or hear, there is always a back story. Ah, right? Maybe the person's having a bad day and fell out of bed when he was in a hurry to get up. Maybe his girlfriend broke up with him. Oh my gosh. Or maybe someone backed up into his car in the parking lot. When we see something we don't like, there's always a backstory. Now, let me give you the backstory of my backstory. My gosh, it's complicated. I'm gonna talk about my name. And people say, your family name is so hard to pronounce. I'll make it easy for you. I'll talk about my first name, okay? Tell me, what do you see? Vivian. I have been called Vivian, Bibian, Lillian, Miriam. Heaven forbid looking like this. I have been called William. Do I look like a William? Hello? Yes, Viola, it hurts. Maybe I need a face change, not a facelift, if I look like a William. But moving over to romance, I didn't go to a Philippine school. I went to an American international school where people from all over the world were there. Had a boyfriend. Not from Australia, not from the Philippines, not from Japan. Alan, not from America, so it's in another continent. I thought it was romantic. He was the head of the soccer team. Of course, every girl wants to be the girlfriend of the captain, right? Yeah. But the backstory of my backstory is, how romantic is it when someone 6'3", me, a little bit over 5 feet, looks at me and I look at him, and he says, I love you, Fifian. What? My face is laughable. Come on, if I'm your girlfriend and you're my boyfriend, the least you can do is memorize how to say my name. You can say everything else wrong, do I look like a Fifian? And it got worse because the name of our dog was Fifi. I didn't look like my dog. So why am I telling you this? The backstory of the backstory of the backstory is, here we are learning presentation mastery. You can mess up on everything, your content, your organization, your delivery. You can mess up everything. But one thing you are accountable and responsible for is to get the name right. And I heard Alan ask a while ago, is that the way to pronounce your name? That's how you know, salute. Alan knows what he's doing. So, to make all of you more confident, more comfortable, and more willing to do anything in this organization, just remember, before the show starts and you have something to say, ask everybody, how would you want me to pronounce your name? Is that doable? Thumbs up? 10? Yes, there you go. Because it is a sign of, believe it or not, respect, love, and care for the person. To call the person by the right name. I know that culturally, our countries don't always say things the right way. Hey, come on, in our country, where are you, Herbert? You know we don't have a V. That's why they've even called me Baby Ann. I'm 73. You're gonna call me Grandma Baby Ann? That's disgusting. Okay? But you have to practice V. Can I tell V? Come on, V. Come on, Herb. You know that they say V. No, no. V. You say it and you say it and you say it. You'll get it right. Okay? And why am I telling you this? Am I being difficult? No. In our country, French is not anywhere in the equation. But I learned to speak French. I travel around Paris alone. I'm completely understood because I made an effort as a sign of respect to the people in France that I will go there and speak French correctly and not give them a stressful situation trying to figure out what? So the backstory of the backstory of the backstory is now I've given you the formula. You can mess up on everything, but if you say their name correctly, they're gonna love you. Because if there's anything any human being wants, it's to hear their name said the right way. And I know a famous poet said something like that, but I'm having a senior moment and I cannot recite poetry. So one day we're just going to practice saying everybody's names here, and practice when we get it right, because we want to show them that we love and care and respect them, and they will love and care and respect us in return. How do you like that for a simple formula on how to be a public speaker, broadcaster, talk show host, and all around wacky girl here on Sunday Sundowners? I've given you a part of my heart, the backstory, the why. A name is so important. Sending you love from Manila. Mwah, mwah, mwah.
Thank you very much, Vivian. V.